Good morning, Anil. How are you doing?
Very well, thank you. But I can't say the same for the rates we're seeing, particularly at the parallel market. BDCs, the Bureau de Change Operators, are being blamed for this wide gap that we're experiencing between parallel market rates and interbank foreign exchange market rates. As you heard me read out just a minute ago, the rates from the interbank is at 310 and 475 at the parallel market, a very whopping 165 margin. What really is going on?
Yes, you see the spike in the foreign exchange market, more especially the segment black market, what we call the parallel market, is volatile. And that market is not the market of the license bureau de change, central bank license bureau de change. There are a lot of operators, but that does not mean the license bureau de change are not concerned. And this is part of our argument that we have been saying, that you cannot remove the license bureau de change from a foreign exchange market. We always have a role to play. Just last week, when a window was opened for us, that is to assess the profit of IMTS profit, we were able to, because of that information and participation, the rate came down from about 495 to almost 465, where we have seen naira recording about 30 naira trend. That is also continuing by this week. That window is open also this week for us to collect. It has been reviewed from $10,000 to $15,000. And we also have the assurance of the Central Bank of Nigeria that the entire $24 billion diaspora remittance that is coming into this country, they will make it exclusively for the use of the bureau de change. What is happening really in the market is sabotage. There are people, speculation, hoarding, inducement from foreign investors. I think on the part of the regulator, they are proactive, they are strategic, they are tactical. They have put a lot of strategic measures, moves to really ensure stability. Part of it, which you are aware, is the restriction of the 41 items, the introduction of the even single foreign exchange market is to address supply in the market. And recently, part of the tactical move is this access they are giving to bureau de change at the window of the international money transfer operator. I know it's too early to see a very positive development, but I can assure Nigerians that this is not the time to continue to attack naira, because both the regulators, the operators, and the security agencies were on top of it. And we can assure Nigerians that very soon we'll begin to see naira gaining its strength. And I also want to use this opportunity to talk on behalf of our members, that members are warned not to be selling above the regulated price. The regulated price we're allowed to sell is $256 to $1. They are not also allowed to be found engaged in bulk trading. That is selling above $4,000, $5,000 maximum. And you can only sell to engage, genuine travelers.
Alhaji Gwadabe, let me quickly cut in
now.
here. So if the Bureau de Change Operators are not responsible for where we see this, for where we see the naira, galloping with such a wide margin, who is responsible? Who is causing the sabotage, like you said? Who is sabotaging the market?
Like I told you, we have a lot of participants in the market. We are talking of hoarding. A lot of Nigerians, because they don't have confidence any longer in the naira, they prefer to buy dollar and keep in their car, keep in their wardrobe, and keep in their farm. And we also have speculators that their own intention, they are mopping up the little other liquidity in the market so that it will not be available, and by then increase the prices so that when it reaches a higher level, they will bring it out to sell. And thirdly, we have the inducement of the.
Alhaji Gwadabe, let me just quickly ask you this question. Some people say that the reason, among other things, although you've mentioned it, is that the association is trying to force the CBN's hand to allow some of its members be part of the FX primary dealers at the interbank foreign exchange market. Do you agree?
You said the association is trying to do what?
It's trying to force the central bank hand in terms of allowing them be participants at the interbank foreign exchange market. Do you agree?
Yes, definitely. Like I've told you, the people have already given their consent. And that's why we have seen the impact, the positive impact in the market. Well, last week, this dollar has gone to about $500. It's just because of the consent for the BDC to access the interbank market. That is why it has come down to 460 something. So you can see the positive in allowing the BDC to participate in that market. Within 1 week, Naira have gained strength of about 35 Naira. And this week, we are also going to assess the market. Next week, we are going to assess with more volume, because more volume are coming into this country through the IMPO profit.
So the will BDC we see
are
the
going
Naira?
To have a lot of.
How quickly will we see the Naira improving? Right now it's at 475. Not a lot of people can afford that. How soon will we see
that
improving?
Yes, definitely. Like I said, I'm not happy Naira is 470-something. And this is a combination of so many factors, like I've mentioned to you before. But I am sure with what the CBN is doing now, with the IMTOs and the Yuridi change, more abroad now, people are selling their money at 325 to a dollar.
Well,
the people in this country.
Thank you
so
much.
The dollar is going to come to that level, I think, between 350 and 370 anytime from now.
Thank you, Alhaji Gwadabe, for shedding light on those issues for us. Business Morning continues in just a moment.